During the beginning of the 20th century, yet another unique American music form developed. When Mexican-American musicians from Texas began to play the accordions brought by immigrants from Germany and Czechoslovakia, the result was Tejano, or Tex-Mex music. Narciso Martinez was one of the pioneers of this form of roots music.
Narciso Martinez was the first one that recorded in Texas, because they didn't know accordion in Mexico in those days. It was in Texas. It started in Texas, in the valley.
Today, Flaco Jimenez is recognized as a virtuoso of the Tejano accordion.
There's a certain type of guitar that we call the brother of the accordion of Tex-Mex, which is a bajo sexto. If there's no bajo sexto in a conjunto band, it's no band at all. So I started playing the accordion, I would say about 5 years old. I come from a musical background from my grandfather, Patricio Jimenez. And then my dad came along and he told me about just playing in birthday parties and celebrations of anniversaries or whatever. But there were house dances. They used to get the furniture out to another room for them to make space to dance.
And they used to sweep the dirt and a big under a big tree, you know, and then they used to hang some of those lamps, gas lamps, you remember, air lamps, and then they used to hang a lot of them though, and then the people used to dance in the dirt.
Valerio Longoria is credited with adding words and a rhythm section to the emerging Tejano music.
I started playing the accordion when I was 7 years old in the valley, and I started practicing, and I learned 3 or 4 polkas, and that's the way I started, you know. And I keep on playing with that little accordion until my father told me, if you learn better, I'll buy you another one. But if you just gonna keep on making noise, just forget it. Forget the accordion, just put it out.
Valerio Longoria has not only been one of the trendsetters for the kind of what we call conjunto music, but also one of the developers of that style of music. One of the things that Valerio did for the accordion music was to integrate a drum set which was not there before, you know. He went like from a snare to the bass to a bass snare tom-tom and a full set of drums. Valerio was actually one of the first accordionists, the vocalists, and the artists before Valerio. They were pretty much all instrumental artists.
Singing was always associated with people drinking, you know, rowdy people. So the conjuntos were trying to make themselves more respectable, and they did that by avoiding any singing. They thought that by playing only instrumental music, they might be accepted. It didn't help. The music continued to be considered cantina music.
I made my first recording with Corona label in San Antonio. So we made one microphone, and they came out good.
Not only did he innovate the music, but the sound of the accordion itself, altering the reeds in the instrument itself. So he produced a unique sound for the accordion.
I remember distinctly going to stores back then in the very early 50s asking for an accordion to sound like Valerio Longoria's accordion, and the man would tell me, well, we'll sell you the accordion as it is, But you have talked to Mr. Longoria into changing it into his thing, because he actually changed the octaves, made an accordion, a regular accordion, sound sort of Cajun-y and different from Conjunto. And to this day, people are still looking for the Longoria sound. How does he do that? Remains still his secret.
The orchestra tradition in the Southwest begins as an alternative to Conjunto among people who consider themselves to be a cut above the common workers.
Starting in the 60s and the 70s, Little Joe and the family began synthesizing a broad range of styles that included ranchero and orquesta music from Mexico with country, blues, swing, and jazz elements. Their song Las Nubes, or The Clouds, written about the hopes and disappointment of the working man, became an unofficial anthem of the Chicano farm workers movement.
I knew that I needed to make a change, and I wanted to do something more with music.
He began to really to blend in all kinds of styles in his music, and he brought in jazz, he brought in country western, and of course he always maintained the ranchera flavor, which was the hallmark of the Conjunto.
I'm an American act, and I do music in two languages. What I've done is taken Mexican traditional Mexican songs and played them with a bluesy or jazzy feel.